Our story takes place in modern-day England, where our two heroes, a brother and sister team, were invited to a party for their mutual friend. However, this was not a happy occasion, because their friend, Charles Ogle, had been diagnosed with type 2 diabetes, which had taken a turn for the worst, and a serious infection had caused both his legs to be amputated. "My friends, these last several months have been difficult for me. I thought my life was as good as over. And then, 3 weeks ago, I was invited to an appointment with a medical company and said I was a perfect patient for their brand new miracle drug. I've brought you all here to witness that in less than a month of treatment, I am completely cured." And to a chorus of gasps and rapturous applause, Bryony and Connor witnessed a man with no legs stand from his wheelchair. The heroes, however, were dumbfounded and suspicious. Bryony was a healthcare assistant and had been looking after Charles for the last few months and did everything she could to make his remaining life more comfortable. But she didn't need a medical degree to know that no medicine in the world can grow legs back. Meanwhile, Connor, a young journalist from a local newspaper, had caught wind of this pharmaceutical company that had seemingly come from nowhere, and yet was causing quite a stir with their immediate success. Both of them had a lot of questions that needed answering. Getting to talk to Charles was proving difficult, so while Connor stepped outside to smoke and talk to some of the party members, Bryony decided to do some snooping around Charles's bedroom for clues, and failed her investigation role. The rules of Call of Cthulhu, for those who aren't familiar, have choices for players who fail their skill roles. They can either just accept the failure, or can do what's called pushing the roll. That is, they can try again, but if they re-roll poorly, bad things will happen. My player chose to push the roll. After rummaging through some paperwork, she found a few letters from Zymed Bio. "At Zymed Bio, your health and wellness are our priority. Using our cutting-edge modern medicine research, your participation in our clinical trial to bring the wonders of our new medication to a wider world. You have been accepted to take part in our study, and we hope that you feel the benefits in just a few days of our program."
"New medication?"
Bryony wondered.
"Is this the miracle drug that helped Charles grow new legs?"
But as Bryony was reading this letter, her player had actually failed her role. So engrossed with trying to find clues in this bedroom, Bryony had failed to hear Charles catching her snooping around, and his once cheery face was now contorted into a dark scowl.
"There you are, Charles."
Bryony turned to face him, slipping the leaflet into her back pocket. Charles said nothing. Instead, animalistic panting seemed to escape his upturned lips.
Charles?
Meanwhile, Connor was wandering around the party, taking a few stories from people and trying to come up with any new leads of his own. Around him, the guests at the party were just getting drunker quickly, and Connor didn't really blame them. Charles's medication had worked. Everyone seemed happy. Maybe he was just looking into this too much. However, his thoughts were cut off as he heard a scream come from a closed door on the other side of the house. Noticing the door was locked, a very impressive strength roll let him bash the door open off its hinges, revealing the creature that once was Charles Ogle. Charles opened his mouth and a huge pink frog-like tongue lolled out of his mouth towards him. "After seeing this," I said to the player, "what would you like to do?" The player thought for a moment and then said, "I want to run up and smack him in the face." If there's one thing Call of Cthulhu has accidentally taught my players, is that if they don't lose much sanity from a monster, then their characters can't possibly be too scared to punch said monster. What happened next was a bizarre fight between Charles, who'd somehow gotten inhumanly stronger as time went on, and Connor, whose player was somehow incapable of failing any roles. Meanwhile, Bryony escaped the room, shutting the door behind her so as not to panic the remaining party guests. In a matter of minutes, Connor landed the killing blow, knocking what was left of Charles onto the floor. Exhausted and in shock, Connor began to leave the room, but not before hearing a strange hissing sound as Charles's body began to dissolve before his own eyes. Quickly, Connor managed to grab his phone and take a couple of pictures before the body liquidated into a puddle. Making sure nobody saw, Bryony and Connor left the house, tired and confused as to what had just happened. Who was this medical company, and what were they doing to their patients? Was what happened to Charles just an accident, or was there something far more sinister happening? They didn't know, but they were going to find out.